Hi, welcome to this session, Complex Integration, Chapter 4. First is definition of bounded variation. Consider a function gamma from closed interval AB to C. For AB belongs subset of R. Gamma is of bounded variation. Gamma is of bounded variation can be written as BV, bounded variation, if there is a constant, M greater than 0 such that for any partition, P equal to A equal to T naught less than T1 less than etc. less than Tm equal to B of AB, and V of gamma with respect to the partition P is equal to summation k equal to 1 to m mod gamma of tk minus gamma of tk minus 1 is less than or equal to m. Then we say that this is a bounded variation. And what do you mean by a total variation? This is a bounded variation. And next definition is total variation. Total variation is defined by V of gamma. It is notated by V of gamma that is equal to V of gamma. V of gamma is equal to supremum of V of gamma P, but P is any partition of AB. Then clearly this is a supremum and this is always less than or equal to, this is V of gamma is less than or equal to M, which is less than infinity. Okay, so V of gamma is defined as V of gamma is equal to supremum of or V of gamma P, where P is a partition of AB. P is a partition of closed interval AB. Okay, then V of gamma is strictly less than or equal to M, which is less than infinity. Next is two important remarks in this. Before this 1.2, we have two important remarks, that is gamma is of bounded variation if and only if real part gamma and imaginary part gamma are of bounded variation. Second one is if gamma is real valued and is not decreasing, then gamma is of bounded variation and this bounded variation, total variation V of gamma is defined by gamma of B minus gamma of A. These two remarks we have to prove. Suppose gamma is of bounded variation. So there exists a partition P such that P on AB such that this V of gamma P is less than or equal to M. And we have to prove that this is real gamma, and suppose let gamma is equal to gamma 1 plus I into gamma 2. Then gamma 1 is a real part and gamma 2 is its imaginary part. So consider this V of gamma 1 based on this partition, and this is equal to summation k equal to 1 to m mod gamma 1 of tk minus gamma 1 of tk minus 1. Okay. this is a real part actually. Real part is always real set. This real part of this is always less than or equal to f itself. So this is less than or equal to the summation mod gamma of tk minus gamma of tk minus 1. So which is less than some, we know that this is less than m for any partition p. So real gamma is of bounded variation. Similarly, what we have to prove? V of gamma 2 partition P2 is equal to summation k equal to 1 to m gamma 2 of tk minus gamma 2 of tk minus 1, which is less than or equal to the summation, similarly as before, gamma of tk minus gamma of tk minus 1 less than m. Okay. Next, what we have to do next is suppose that gamma is real gamma and imaginary gamma are of bounded variation. So V of gamma 1 based on partition P is less than some m1, and V of gamma 2 based on some partition P2 is less than m2. So this is less than m2. So by using the so this m is equal to here. Suppose that real gamma and imaginary gamma are of bounded variation. So the bounded variation corresponding to gamma 1 with respect to the partition P1 is less than some M1, and there is an M2 such that the bounded variation corresponding to gamma 2 with respect to the partition P2 is less than M2. Let P be the partition of AB such that P contains P1 union P2. Okay, and M is equal to supremum of M1 comma M2. Supremum of M1 comma M2. Then what happened? Then clearly we can see that this is summation summation mode gamma of tk minus gamma of tk minus 1 is less than or equal to summation gamma 1 of tk minus gamma 1 of tk minus 1 plus sigma mod gamma 2 of tk minus gamma 2 of tk minus 1. Okay, and this is less than m1 plus m2, and we can say that this is some m. No need to choose this m here. M is equal to supremum, and this is, which is equal to m. So this means gamma is of bounded variation. So this is a proof actually. Second remark is that if gamma is real valued and is non-decreasing then gamma is a then gamma is a bounded variation. Gamma is of bounded variation. How will you prove this? Unbounded variation, the total variation V of gamma is written by gamma of B minus gamma of A. I'll give some hints only. If gamma is real valued and on decreasing means it is increasing. So if it is a constant also, then we can see that this is of bounded variation. So if since it is non decreasing, it is increasing. So V of gamma with respect to the partition, I'm not taking this gamma, I am not stating this gamma, what is gamma, what is P, these gamma and partition P as we defined earlier, this is the definition. Okay, so this is equal to summation k equal to 1 to m mod gamma of tk minus gamma of tk minus 1. Tk minus 1. We know that since it is an increasing function, gamma of tk minus gamma of tk minus 1 is always positive. So summation k equal to 1 to m, no need to take this modulus. So this is gamma of tk minus gamma of tk minus 1. Adding this gamma of, this is t1 minus gamma of t0 plus gamma of t2 minus gamma of t1 plus etc. plus gamma of tk tm minus gamma of tm minus 1. And this get cancelled. So the remaining is actually, remaining term is, that is gamma of tm minus gamma of t0, which implies gamma of B minus gamma of A. Okay. So, and this is of bounded variation actually. This is less than, and this is equal to gamma B minus gamma of A. So, which is less than some constant M. So, we can see that this is of bounded variation and the total variation is gamma of B minus gamma of A. 1.2 proposition. Let P is equal to A equal to T0, T1, etc. Tm is equal to B is a partition and Q is another partition for this A and B. Let K belongs to Ki and this Q. Q actually, the partition Q. When if k equal to tj for some j, then sum does not change. If k not equal to tj, given that p is contained in q. Okay. So we can choose a k such that which is not is in, not belongs to, not equal to tj for every j. Okay. That means K lies in between. K is not equal to any of this Tj. Then K lies in between two points Tk, Tk minus 1 in Tj 0 to n. Then consider summation I equal to 0 to k minus 1 gamma of Ti minus gamma of T I minus 1 plus gamma of Tk minus gamma of Tk minus 1 plus summation k plus 1 to n gamma of T I minus gamma of T I minus 1. So consider mode gamma of Tk minus gamma of Tk minus 1. which is equal to mod gamma of tk minus gamma of k plus gamma of k minus gamma of tk minus 1, which is less than or equal to mod gamma of tk minus gamma of, this is some ki and gamma of ki plus mod gamma of ki minus gamma of tk minus 1. So we have gamma of tk minus gamma of tk minus 1 can be written as this one. So consider summation I equal to 0 to k gamma of t I equal to 1 I equal to 1 to n gamma of tk minus gamma of tk minus 1. Okay, ti not tk, that is ti. Ti minus ti minus ti minus 1. So which is equal to, which is less than or equal to summation. Each gamma kth interval is less than or equal to this one. Okay. So this is less than or equal to corresponding to this ki. Sigma I equal to 1 to, this is n plus 1 actually. N plus 1 gamma of ti minus gamma of ti minus 1 is actually. Okay. One interval is actually increased to here. Here, I have written this like because here actually one variable is increased, ki is increased. So, relabel this partition with the extra points as relabel the partition with the extra point as ti 0 less than or equal to I less than or equal to n plus 1. So we can see that this is a partition of this Q actually. So this is V of gamma with respect to P is less than or equal to V of gamma with respect to Q. So the theorem is proved. Similarly, we can see that if sigma from closed interval AB to C is also bounded variation and alpha and beta are complex variable, then alpha gamma plus beta sigma is of bounded variation and V of alpha gamma plus beta sigma is less than or equal to mod alpha into V of gamma plus mod beta into V of sigma. This can be done as in the previous case because sigma is of bounded variation and given that gamma is of bounded variation. So we can